Let's compare Windows 7 to Mac OS X 10.8 Mountain Lion. On the left we have Windows 7, which was released in 2009, and on the right we have Mac OS X 10.8 Mountain Lion, which was released in 2012. In Windows 7 there is a taskbar at the bottom. In Mac OS 10.8 there is a dock at the bottom and a bar at the top. In Windows 7 the taskbar has a start button at the left. It then has pinned programs, and when you click one it turns into the running program. When you open a new program that is not pinned, it shows up on the taskbar while it is open. At the right of the taskbar it has notifications, a clock and a show desktop button. In Mac OS 10.8 the dock at the bottom works very similar to the taskbar in Windows 7. It contains pinned programs and they turn into the running program when you click them. When you open a new program that is not kept in the dock, it shows up in the dock while it is open. The top bar has the Apple logo at the left, which brings up the Apple menu, which contains system options. It then has the name of the current application. It then has the menus for the current application, which change depending on which application is active. At the right it has system icons, clock, username, search and notifications. In Windows 7 the title bar is transparent glass. In Mac OS 10.8 the title bar is 3D and silver. In Windows 7 the X maximize and minimize buttons are at the right, in Mac OS 10.8 they are at the left. In Windows 7 the X button is red and the minimize and maximize buttons are blue. In Mac OS 10.8 the X button is red, the minimize button is orange and the maximize button is green. In Windows 7 the X maximize and minimize buttons are rounded rectangles that are joined to the top. In Mac OS 10.8 they are circles. In Windows 7 the title is left aligned, in Mac OS 10.8 it is centered. In Windows 7 the menu bar for the current program is inside the window of that program. In Mac OS 10.8 the menu bar for the current program is on the system bar at the top. In Windows 7 when you minimize a program it moves down into the taskbar, in Mac OS 10.8 it pours down into the dock. In Windows 7 taskbar icons for programs that are running have a box around them, in Mac OS 10.8 dock icons for applications that are running have an indicator light underneath them. In Windows 7 programs minimize into their taskbar icon. In Mac OS 10.8 they minimize into a separate thing at the right of the dock, and when you have multiple instances minimized they show up separately as thumbnails, they only show up when minimized. In Windows 7 when you have multiple instances of the same program open, they show up as thumbnails when you click on the taskbar icon, regardless of whether they are minimized. In Windows 7 when you hold the mouse over taskbar icons there is a glow the color of the icon that follows the mouse. In Mac OS 10.8 when you hold the mouse over the dock the icons get bigger. In Windows 7 the recycle bin is on the desktop. In Mac OS 10.8 the trash is at the right of the dock. In Windows 7 to show all programs you click start and then all programs. In Mac OS 10.8 you click launchpad, which is on the dock. In Windows 7 the places are on the top right of the start menu. In Mac OS 10.8 you click on the Go menu when Finder is active. In Windows 7 the username is in the top right of the start menu. In Mac OS 10.8 it is at the right of the top bar. In Windows 7 control panel is on the start menu. In Mac OS 10.8 system preferences is in the Apple menu. In Windows 7 there is a shutdown button in the bottom right corner of the start menu, and there is an arrow next to it which brings up switch user, log off, lock, restart and sleep. In Mac OS 10.8 sleep, restart, shutdown and logout are in the Apple menu, and to switch user you click on the username which is at the right of the top bar. In Windows 7 the clock is at the right of the taskbar. In Mac OS 10.8 the clock is at the right of the system bar. In Windows 7 the application that runs both the desktop and the file manager is called Explorer. In Mac OS 10.8 the application that runs both the desktop and the file manager is called Finder. In Mac OS 10.8 some applications such as Notes and Calendar have a different texture in their title bar, and they also look like a page has been ripped off at the top. Contacts also looks like it's a book. Some applications such as Notes also have a full screen button in the top right which hides the menu bar and the dock. Putting the mouse to the top of the screen then brings up the menu bar, and there is a button to restore the application to a window. In Windows 7, in some programs such as File Explorer the arrow from the title bar extends down into the application. In Mac OS 10.8 in some applications the silver from the title bar extends down into the application. In Windows 7 you can change the window color. In Mac OS 10.8 you can change the appearance and highlight color. In Windows 7 you can pin your own programs to the taskbar. In Mac OS 10.8 you can keep your own applications in the dock. In Windows 7 the taskbar is at the bottom by default, but it can also be moved to the left, to the right or to the top. In Mac OS 10.8 the dock is at the bottom by default but can also be moved to the left or to the right. The system bar is at the top and cannot be moved. In Windows 7 there is an option to use small taskbar icons. In macOS 10.8 you can change the size of the icons on the dock and you can choose whether they get bigger when you hold the mouse over them. In Windows 7 you can have the taskbar buttons always combine and hide labels, combine when taskbar is full or never combine. In macOS 10.8 you can choose whether applications minimize to a thumbnail at the right of the dock or minimize to their icon. You can also choose whether to show indicator lights for open applications. In Windows 7 there is a button at the right of the taskbar to show hidden icons. In macOS 10.8 there is a button at the right of the top bar to bring up the notifications pane which looks like a piece of fabric. In Windows 10 there is a button at the right of the taskbar which brings up a notification pane. In Windows 7 the mouse arrow is white. In macOS 10.8 the mouse arrow is black. In Windows 7 you can close programs that are not responding by using Task Manager which you can open by right-clicking the taskbar then clicking Task Manager, pressing Ctrl-Shift-Escape or pressing Ctrl-Alt-Delete then clicking Start Task Manager. In macOS 10.8 you can close applications that are not responding by using Force Quit which you can open from the Apple menu or by pressing Command-Option-Escape. In Windows 7 you can add gadgets to the desktop. In macOS 10.8 you can add widgets to the dashboard. In macOS 10.8 you can have multiple desktops with different applications open, in Windows 7 you cannot. In Windows 10 you can have multiple desktops with different apps open. In Windows 7 the default web browser is Internet Explorer, in macOS 10.8 the default web browser is Safari. Let's compare the login screen. In Windows 7 it has a blue leafy background, in macOS 10.8 it has a gray fabric background. In Windows 7 it has the name of the operating system in the bottom center, in macOS 10.8 it has the Apple logo in the top center. In Windows 7 there is an ease of access button in the bottom left corner, in macOS 10.8 there is not. In Windows 7 it has a shutdown button in the bottom right corner with an arrow next to it that brings up restart and sleep, in macOS 10.8 in the bottom center it has sleep, restart and shutdown. In macOS 10.8 it has a clock in the top right, in Windows 7 it does not. In Windows 10 it has a clock on the locked screen. In Windows 7 the profile pictures are square, in macOS 10.8 they are round. In Windows 10 the profile pictures are round. Goodbye.